Hi, this is Munson with Munson Music, and we're going to talk about how you can play a song called Sippin' on Fire by Florida Georgia Line. And we end up caping this on 4th fret to kind of match the recording. We'll walk through a couple things in reposition just in case you don't have a capo. And we're going to start on our main intro progression on an E minor chord. I normally do this first finger on the A second, second finger on the D second. And if you strum all those together, all the sad sounds of E minor. And you may also dig on adding in the third finger on the B third, pinky on the high third. Kind of working that as an E minor 7. And then from the E minor, we'll be going to a C major chord. I normally do this first finger on the B first fret, second finger on the D second, third finger on the A third. If you strum the A string to the high E string, the beautiful sounds of C major. Now, you may also dig on lifting off the first finger and making it C major 7, or you can add in the pinky on the B third for C major 9 and kind of say some stuff around it. Or another way to play C major 9, we'll be doing first finger on the D second, second finger on the A third, third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third, and then if you strum all those together, it's another way to play C major 9. And then from the C, we can go into a G major chord. Normally, you do this first finger on the A second, second finger on the low E third, third finger on the high E third. If you strum all those together, the beautiful sounds of G major. You may also dig on putting third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third, working that for your G major. And then from the G, we'll be going to a D major. You do this first finger on the G second, second finger on the high E second, and then third finger on the B third. And if you strum the D string to the high E string, the beautiful sounds of D major. And you may also dig on lifting off the second finger and making that a D sus 2, or you could add in the pinky on the high E third for a D suspended and kind of say some stuff around it. And through the tune, actually, there's a couple different strumming options you may want to play around with. You could do kind of a 4 down count on each chord, kind of Mach 2, 3, 4, C, 2, 3, 4, G, 2. Bit of right hand move just to make that a little sneaky, or you could use a strum pattern. One of my favorite strum patterns for a 4/4 like this is down, down, up, up, down, up. So we took the E minor and just tried that a lot. You have down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Now there's a couple ways you could kind of apply that, and this is kind of a slow tempo deal with this pattern. You could do just a down, down, up, kind of half the pattern on each chord. C, down, up, G, down, up, A, down, up. Or you could split the pattern between the chords and do the E minor with a down, down, up. And then go to the C for the up, down, up. And G with a down, down, up. And D with a up, down, up. So you kind of dig on it that way. So E minor. Stuff, I like anticipating things, and it can be cool to do the E minor with a down, down, and then go to the C for the up, up, down, up, G with the down, down, and then D with the up, up, down, up. So the E minor down, down, C on the up, up, down, G down, 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 up, up, down, E minor down. What I really think kind of matches the tune better is something called a 16th note strum pattern. And what I mean by that is if you're tapping your foot at the beat, right now we're dividing that beat into two parts with our down, down, up, up, down, up. One, two, one, two. That's called an 8th note. What a 16th note is where you divide that beat into four parts. So one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And one of my favorite 16th note strum patterns is a long down, 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 up, up, down, down, up, down. And what I mean by that is if you take the E minor and do it down for four. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. That's what you can do on the first beat. Then on the second beat, you do it down on one, down on three, up on four. So you're going one, two, three, four, down, 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 down. And then on the third beat, you do it up on two, down on three. So you're going one, two, three, four, one, up, down, one, down, one, up, down. And then on the last beat, you go down, up, down, up, right along with the one, two, three, four. So down, 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 down. So all together, you got down, 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 down. There's a couple ways you could kind of apply that to that main intro. And we could do just the down, down, down up on each chord. Or we could split the pattern and do the E minor with the down, 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 up. And then go to the C for the up, down, down, up, down, up. First verse actually kind of matches that same feel, so you can actually work any of those patterns that we've been talking about. Do that twice. Then we have kind of a big hit on a C chord. We just kind of rot out the C. And then we pick it up on our chorus. And our chorus kind of halves the C to our G chord. And then we do our whole pattern on the D. Part is to play along with Florida Georgia Line. Instead of starting on an E minor chord, they're starting on a G sharp minor chord. So to play along with the recording, what you want to do is take a capo, and if you put the capo on 4th fret, then now your E minor is really a G sharp minor, and your C is really an E major, and your G is really a B major chord, and your D is really an F sharp major chord. So take it from the very beginning on the intro. You could use any of those ways we've been talking about, kind of the down count idea. C. Down up. Or you can kind of split that pattern. You can use the 16th idea. Or you can split that pattern. And from there, then we're going into our first verse. And you can use any of those ways we've been talking about. Minor C, or even mixing up between them can be cool. E minor C, G, D. Kind of hit our big C chord. And then from there, then we go into our chorus part. So we tried that with a down, down, up, up, down, up. C, D. Song though is bass notes, and a lot of times on that first down of the down, down, up, up, down, up, you throw in a bass note for the chord. So on the E minor, you have low E for the bass, on the C, you have the A for the bass, on the G, you have low E for the bass, and on the D, you have the D for the bass. So there's a couple ways we can apply that. We can try just a bass down up on each chord just to get used to that. Kind of E minor, down, up, C. Idea, you can work it off a couple different variations. You work it off a bass down, down, up, up, down, 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 or a bass, bass, down, down, up, up, down, 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 or a bass, bass, down, down, up, up, bass, down, up, down. It'd be very cool. So you could work just a bass down, down, up on each one. Is kind of E minor with the bass down, down, up, and then go to the C for the up bass, down, up, down, up, and then G with the bass down, down, up, and then D with the up bass down, down. So we try it that way. And E minor, C, G, D, E minor, C, G, D. And from that intro return, then to our next verse. You can mix that up either of those ways. E minor, C, G, D. E minor, C, G, D. That's twice, and we got our big C chord. And then we go into our chorus. So we tried that with a bass down, up, up, down, up. We have a C, G, D. That with the bass down, up, up, down, up. You have the E minor, C, G, D, E minor, C, G, D. And then we have our whole pattern on the C, and our whole pattern on the D. Or if we tried that with our 16th, we have the E minor, C, other licks around these chords too, you know, feel free to take this lesson and run with it any way you want to, kind of add in things that you know, or if you know the strum patterns that feel pretty good, you know, feel free to take the lesson and kind of run with it. And from there, then we'll be going into our outro, which is kind of like our intro. Cool to kind of switch between those ideas, or mixing them up in different ways. And I know at the very, very end they don't do this, but I think for myself, I really want to play it in E minor just to kind of make people wet. But that's the basics of how you can strum through Sippin' on Fire by Florida Georgia Lines. Good luck! Wherever you are in YouTube land, this is Munson Summer with Munson Music Live, Munson Guitar Songs, Munson Covers, and Munson Jam Tracks. Thanking you for watching this video, and I hope you got something out of this video. I hope you like this video and subscribe to the channel to see lots more like it. I'm always open to your requests. If you have a song that you love, please let me know so I can write it down on the request list so I can add that to it, because there are probably other people out there who love that song too and would love to learn how to play it. So thanks so much for all the love that you give me, and I hope that you're doing well and kind of figuring out how you can talk with the instrument. We are a small music shop in the middle of nowhere in South Carolina, and you're supporting us by watching this channel. Really appreciate all that love. So best of luck, and let me know if there's anything that I can do to help you in particular, too. You can contact me on Facebook. You can leave a message here in the comments section, and I respond to all the comments that I get. So, best of luck to you wherever you are.